It's clear a great battle was fought here recently. Wait, is that someone over there? She doesn't look like a zombie.
Please, can you help me? If you can't drive the hungry dead back, I'll never make it. The Thunderhorn zombies and Moonfall zombies are both hungry. Hungry dead, like you were trained in the Pyramid of the Black Sun. You've bought me a little time. Can you find some of the glowing Isar mushrooms? You can find some near the dwellings. Some. These have strong healing properties. Thank you. You were sent here to look for the Badge of Leadership? Of course! King Axaya's rule is imperiled without it. Our last king, Akampi Rithis, still wore the badge when he was dragged off by the hungry dead into the mines. You need to delve into the deepest mines to find Akampi Rithis and recover the Badge of Leadership. I believe King Akampi Rithis was killed by the hungry dead, but no one knows for certain.
dragged King Akampi down here. I tried to follow, but they caved in the path behind them. Can you get through? Each crystal will break through one type of layer, but if you choose wrong, the hungry dead will come a-running.
Greetings, outsider. I am the true king of the Aztecosaurs. My rule extends from even beyond death. Prepare to slake my hunger. of leadership from my cold, dead hands. Oh, wait.
You do as the fallen king said, and remove the badge of leadership from his cold, dead hands. However, it continues to radiate with a strong feeling of death and the underworld.
You have recovered the badge of leadership. Well done, young magician. King Acampirithi's demise will be recorded as a great tragedy, but at least we know his final fate. You are right, young magician. The badge of leadership has become corrupted by death magic. While that would be fine for an undead king, it's not so fitting for a new untested ruler. You'll need to reconsecrate it before returning it. There are several things we will need. Collect rogue gold from around the mines. You'll also need fire quetzal venom. You can get some from the fire quetzals kept by the dwellings. Finally, you'll have to gather broken calendar stone pieces by battling the moonskull zombies who stole them. You managed to get everything so fast? Good work! In order to reconsecrate the badge of leadership, you'll need to reassemble the calendar stone in the Pyramid of White Fire. The revealed calendar stone will melt the raw gold so you can reshape the badge, and the fire quetzal venom will burn out the corruption. But the pyramid has been occupied by Skirky Screaming Moon, a necromancer who has thrown herself over to the Shadow Queen.
This irresistible creature who has an insatiable love for the dead, you ask? I am Skurky Screaming Moon!
With Skirka's screaming moon out of the way, you were able to put the calendar stone pieces back together. Despite having been broken by some immense force, the calendar stone pieces fit together perfectly. You place the raw gold atop it, and it melts to restore the badge of leadership. Finally, you apply the fire quetzal venom, and the traces of corruption burn away.
You defeated Skirky's Screaming Moon so easily? You fight like one of the great beast-footed carnivores. Take the newly reconsecrated Badge of Leadership back to King Axaya Knife Moon in 3 points. With luck, this will be the symbol he needs to unify the people around him. I'll return to the Sokalo myself.